Today, Community Hub. Here I am again, CryptoWes, and we're at day 9 of the May the Blockchain Be With You challenge. And the assignment for day 9 of the May the Blockchain Be With You challenge is spend at least 5 to 10 minutes reading recent news on Cointelegraph. News, of course, it's if you're interested in the crypto world, good to follow. Let me put myself there. To follow the news, Cointelegraph is a good site. They have awesome pictures, I think. They create all of them, especially for each article they have. It's always good to know or to be aware of what site you are on. Cointelegraph is really a site specialized about coins, about cryptocurrencies, and so not mainstream media. But it's a good site to follow, and if you like it, if you like to keep track of what's happening, look at that site once a day or once a week, whatever your fancy is. Another site you can take a look at is, for example, news.bitcoin.com. Of course, this is more Bitcoin related. Another one is cnn.com/crypto. But well, the articles on CCN, so not CNN, but CCN, crypto coin or cryptocurrency news. They are more like FUD, fear, uncertainty and doubt, fear, uncertainty and doubt messages. So it's always good to, when you read an article, see what the source is and perhaps click on to find the source and read that article, because sometimes they kind of give their own twist. Let's say it that way. For example, this one: fastest horse Bitcoin blasts toward $10,000 as Paul Tudor Jones backs BTC. Well, is he really backing BTC, or did he somewhere say something that might be interpreted as positive? Well, when you go down here, you see a source, Twitter. You can follow that link and see where it came from. You could always, in this case, just Google on Bitcoin and Paul Tudor Jones, or look at Paul Tudor Jones's own Twitter feed to see what he really says about it. Sometimes people respond. Another source you might use is CNBC. CNBC is, of course, a more mainstream media. Sometimes you see that in mainstream media they kind of lack the time, or they don't do good enough efforts to really understand what's happening. But well, okay, it is out there. Some people see this news, so it's good to be aware what a site like CNBC is saying. These are all sites with articles, and it's always good to think, that's what I started my talk about, started my talk with, to think what would be their aim, and what do they want to tell you. Some sites are more pro-crypto, so they see everything through like a positive glasses. They look at the world and at the crypto world, and every news that's positive, they blow it up, and it's huge. And for example, this is a Dutch, it's on YouTube, it's a BTC Direct. It's a Dutch party that's a company that sells Bitcoin and Litecoin and a few other coins. So it's good to know if you, for example, choose to follow this, that it's also very biased. They want you to buy Bitcoin and to sell Bitcoin. So when the price is up, they are like really enthusiastic about that. It's going up, 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 so buy. If it's going down, well, then buy the dip, buy, buy, buy. So always keep that in the back of your mind. This one is for Dutch people. It might be interesting because they make videos around 14, 13 minutes about the news. Another guy, more internationally orientated, I've been following him for quite some time now, is Ivan on Tech. He presents himself as a developer that talks about cryptocurrencies and blockchains. He also has his own teaching platform. And what is funny about him, what he does is every day, even in the weekends, he does kind of a wake up with Ivan on Tech, and he talks about the news, and well, he is very knowledgeable about a lot of things in this space, so he might be interesting to follow. So this was my post about news. Have fun following the news, and always be aware what their own interest is of the one that is writing something or telling something. Okay, have a good day, have a good weekend. See you next time. Bye bye.